direction, we don't lose this way. I don't know exactly what the future holds, but even if we lost it all, don't lose it.
Hey guys, welcome to a new build series on my channel. Behind me is my new 420 Renegade, or new to me, 420 Renegade 2013 model. I picked it up yesterday, pretty cheap, no motor. So this series is going to be about, you know, doing all the little things like new floors and setting up the wiring and the batteries and lights, all that kind of stuff, mounting the motor, and maybe a little bit of trailer work as well. So today's first job is to give the boat a really good clean. As you can see, it's really dirty. It's got lots of salt etching on it. So the product I'm going to be using is this Boat Care aluminium cleaner I picked up. I got to dilute it 10 to 1. And hopefully that'll give it a good clean up. But the first job before we actually get to cleaning the boat is I'm gonna remove all the floors. So I'm gonna pull out this rear panel. I've already pulled that one out. I'm gonna pull out the rear panels down in there, pull these main floors out, pull these hatches out, and I'll pull the foam out as well from underneath the floors. So we're gonna pull the foam out because that way, when it comes time to building the new floor, it's gonna be a lot easier and nicer and just a bit cleaner in there. So we're not dealing with all the gross dirt underneath the floors. So I'll take you for the cleaning process. So each of the major floor panels here has got 12 screws in it total, and then you got to pull the seat spigots out. So this plastic piece here, which I've already pulled out of these two floors here, you got to undo those screws, and then that floor pretty much pulls straight out, slides out, and we'll chuck that on the grass so we can clean under there and stuff. So now that I've removed all the floorboards that I want to get rid of, probably give it a quick vacuum first, and then we'll start hosing with the and cleaning with the aluminium cleaner. Got it all vacuumed out now. Got all the big chunks, big leaves and stuff, all out of the hull. Just all the stuff that couldn't fit out of the bung. So now we'll fire up the Karcher, and then I'll dilute it into the snow foam cannon, and then we'll try that, and if not, we'll just might have to wipe it on normally. It's getting dark now and I'm having no luck with the aluminium cleaner stuff. It's not doing too much really, other than just making some weird stain lines. I tried strong. But as you can see, just leaving these marks down the side of the boat, which isn't an issue on the hull side because I'm gonna plan on getting it wrapped anyway. But I was more so trying to clean this up and all these bits along here, like this. And the cleaner didn't really do much for them, so I'm gonna have to try and find another solution to clean it all up. But it's getting dark now, so I'll see how much I can get done. Righto guys, I'm off to Yatla this morning before work to drop the tinny off. I've got the tinny behind the car. Drop the tinny off down to Joel at 53 Designs to get its wrap today. So that's the first big moment of the boat, is getting the wrap on. Pick it up with Savo, hopefully it actually looks good. Just pulling up to 5-3 Designs now to pick up the tinny, the Savo. Pretty keen to see how it looks. Just got the boat home, and as you can see behind me, she's fully wrapped. Here's what she looks like. I think it looks sick. We've got the regos done in white and with a black outline. I think it looks real good. Contrast for the rest of the boat. We'll get a new Quintrex sticker on the back there. But I reckon it looks great. So the colour is called 3M Gloss Storm Grey. And I reckon it looks great, especially with the rest of the tinny that's not painted. I thought it'd be a good way to not make all that stand out and just kind of look clean and just fresh. I reckon it looks absolutely killer. Never gonna love me, but it's alright. She think I'm an asshole, she think I'm a player. She keep running back though, only cause I pay her.